disturbing product tampering investigation. Officers say a customer at a CVS store in Mandarin bought several enemas, used them, and then returned them to the store.
Police say their investigation leads them to believe this crime was committed over the course of several weeks during March and April. Channel 4's Ashley Townsend is joining us now to tell us how someone would be able to do such a thing. Ashley?
We're told that all those returns were made according to CVS store policy, but after talking with those in the industry, even talking with an attorney, they say that it is a policy that needs to change.
You look at the product, make sure it hasn't been used. If it has been and it can't be reused, of course, we'd discuss that with the patient and probably wouldn't want to take it back.
The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office is launching a product tampering investigation after they say a customer at this Mandarin CVS bought several enemas over the course of weeks, used them, and subsequently returned them. Steve Stafford is a pharmacist here at the Robert South Bank Pharmacy. He knows all too well the importance of secure packaging.
The outside packaging is closed and glued shut, and we'd expect to see that kind of a package.
With a product that's so personal like this, and quite frankly, as intimate as this, it got us wondering if there was a policy in place that would prevent someone from returning this product to the store.
According to CVS's website, their current return policy allows you to bring in any unopened, damaged, or defective non-prescription item. We talked with John Phillips, a local attorney who specializes in both criminal and civil law. He says while they were following their own store policy, something along the way should have raised a red flag.
They've got three, four, five within the same store, within the same, you know, period. That's what raises concerns and creates civil liability on CVS.
And not just civil liability. Channel 4's crime and safety analyst Ken Jefferson says if the customer who did this is knowingly infected with some type of disease, any resulting criminal charges could be grave.
If you know you have a known disease or ailment of some sort and you intentionally and willfully inflict that on someone else, that's a very serious offense.
Bottom line, according to Phillips, despite the store return policy, a different decision, a better decision, should have been made.
It's entirely within their discretion to take it back, and then it's entirely within their discretion to either send it back to the manufacturer or put it back on the shelves or discard it. And they did the worst of the three scenarios, and they put it back on the shelves.
We talked with CVS over the phone. They tell us that the store located off San Jose at Sunbeam is the only store where this took place. They tell us that they are considering a return policy and products packaging change. Police believe that these returns were made during the March-April timeframe. So if you believe that you may have purchased an enema at that CVS location during that time frame, you are suggested that you contact the information found at that store location. And naturally, you can log on to our web channel. That's newsforjax.com for the latest. Mary?